you at the time?
Was heading up to play a couple games.
On January the 18th, 1958, the Bruins called the Quebec Aces and says, we want O'Ree to meet the Bruins in Montreal to play two games against the Montreal Canadiens.
O'Ree did what Jackie Robinson had done 11 years earlier, integrate a white sport as a black professional.
Holy crap. Oh my God. Here we go. Yo, what? This room's like one of those rooms that are like, this feels like a Japanese fancy high-tech room. Welcome room. Dude, this is wild. These rooms are crazy, no?
I know, this is nuts.
I already posted
look
on my story.
Look at the bridge, bro.
I already posted on my story.
Look at the
bro.
Here. Here. The video. Wait.
One of the people in the elevator with us is she's the VP of.
That's Brian McBride. He's the reason we were in Boston. A Williston alumni and legend, Brian attended Williston 1 year to play hockey in American high school before playing at West Point. He transferred to Trinity College in Connecticut after his freshman year. After school, he became vice president of the NHL's business development. One of the first things that Bryant did with this job was that he found Willie O'Ree in the 1990s working as a security guard and hired him as the NHL's diversity ambassador.
She's the VP of marketing for Bauer. It's Mark Messier's sister.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she was in the elevator with us. She's over there.
Hi, Freddy, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling excellent, man. I'm feeling like a brand new man at this place. I'll tell you what, man. This chicken, the mashed potatoes, asparagus, you see, they're gone. They used to be there. Done. Tapped.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Good evening. My name is Brian McBride. When they told Willie last year that he was going to have his jersey retired, he said, the only first thing he said was, I'm overwhelmed. I know exactly how he's feeling right now.
I am always so touched by these stories because I remember how I felt about the players that I looked up to. One of those players was the great Herb Carnegie.
Herb Carnegie was the best black player never to play in the National Hockey League. Jean Beliveau, the Montreal Canadiens legend, played with Herb on the Quebec Aces. Beliveau would later say in his biography, it is my belief Herbie was excluded from the NHL because of his color.
I asked Mr. Beliveau once who the five greatest players he ever played with, and Herb was on that list.
After retiring from professional hockey, Herb became a successful financial advisor and started the Future Aces Hockey School, dedicated to help youths grow in a positive way through hockey. Herb was also a successful senior golfer, winning the Ontario Senior Tour Championship in 1977 and 78. The Carnegie Initiative was co-founded by Brian McBride and Herb's daughter Bernice to continue Herb's legacy of inclusion in the sport of hockey. The initiative believes no one should be pushed away from the great game because of how they look or who they are.
All right, check this out.
I wonder if it keeps that long. Anyway, we'll check WMJX Skywatch traffic for you now on a beautiful Monday morning in Boston, 55 degrees. Skies are clear. And Rich Kirkland says that the bright sunshine is going to affect traffic coming in.
6:45 right now. We're getting ready for the day. Should be pretty interesting. It's going to be a long day, but it's going to be a lot of fun. Here we go.
Who's the greatest American player, they will probably say Julie Chu.
Thank you, Brian. Good morning, everyone. This has been an incredible morning, and I congratulate Brian and the Carnegie Initiative in putting this together. We are seeing a change in the culture of hockey. It's not something that's going to happen overnight. It's something that's going to take a lot of hard, intentional work for it to be successful. And there's never an end point. It's just a journey that everybody is going to have to do together if we're going to get to a place where we become more diverse, more inclusive, more equal, more anti all the things that we should be anti. And it's initiatives like the Carnegie initiatives that gives us an opportunity for all stakeholders in the game to be heard. The only way that we can move forward and stand for all the things that this game should stand for is by beginning to have this conversation.
If I keep holding out, will the light shine through under this broken roof? It's only rain that I feel. I've been wishing I